All right, here I am. Mic is unmuted. Let me take a quick look at my mic real quick. I've been noticing a few little funky things. I just want to take a quick peek at it. Microphone. Okay, everything should be correct. I just want to make sure. All right, now let me get it so it's facing me. All right. Just wanted to make sure that everything was still correct on my mic, that nothing had gotten messed up. And, yeah, that's about it. All right, we are back. We are here with the Umbrella Archives. We're taking a quick Resident Evil break to play a little bit of Metal Gear in honor of Metal Gear Solid Master Collection having just been released. We're kind of doing a little bit of a short intro today, and we're not bothering with the studio intro for right now, just because I'm going to go right into the video game. But, here we go, let's turn everything up so I can hear it. There it is, I hope everyone's doing well. What's up, Controller Freak, how's it going? What is up to anyone else who is just now joining or lurking? Game selection, North American, English. Alright. Oh, let me turn on my webcam mic. It's a little dark in here. Give me a sec. Ah. Oh, and Stu Pickles said, "Let there be light." He said that at one point.
Stu, what are you doing?
Making chocolate pudding.
It's 4 o'clock in the morning. Why on earth are you making chocolate pudding?
Because I've lost control of my life.
All right, I'm all comfortable. I'm sore today. I went to the gym, I did legs, and then I had to mow the lawn, the front and back lawn, both of which had gotten long. Even though it's late October, it was like 85 degrees and sunny where I am. I might even be a little sunburned. But it's been quite a day. Oh, for once you can't relate. Oh man, that sounds like a good thing. All right, we're going to load up our file. File number 2 here. Try to remember exactly where I am. Here I am. All right, this part can be annoying. Oh, Tuxedo Snake, that's right. All right, what I'm going to try to do here is knock out this scientist that's going to be trying to give me some crap. I have no footstep sound. Let's see if I can just get him. Hey, that actually worked out pretty good. It's not always that simple. Alright, we got scientists in here. Believe me when I say it's not always that simple. Hopefully everything sounds good. Do I sound good? Does the game sound good? I hope everything sounds good. I'm always paranoid that it's not gonna sound good. Right, hold on. Hold on. He goes, Scientist, sound levels seem good. Well, if they seem good to casual, that's really all I need. Don't care about nobody else. I ain't asking, are they good for everyone on the earth? I'm asking, are they good for casual? Yo, what's up, Capricorn? I don't know why I said that so crazy. But how's it going? Welcome. Play Metal Gear. Ah, pop, 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 pop. Scientists, I have to be careful. Alright, hold on. I have to legit be careful. No! That's an alert. I can't have it. I gotta reload. It sucks. This one part of the game is really tough. Return to title screen. It's annoying, but that's the way it goes. You're doing well, of course. Reading and watching you, laughing my ass off, your stream, haha. OFC, I'm doing well. I don't know what OFC stands for. There's a lot of shorthand terms that I don't always know. Of course, oh, it is of course, I guessed it right. Hey, I loaded up my favorite one. My favorite one's the orange one with the planes and the peace signs. Because look, you can change the patterns. And you could change the colors. See? Just by chance, I got my favorite. The orange one. What are the chances? Where is it? There! What are the chances of that? That I got my favorite? Probably one out of like 112 or something. Just estimating that I got my favorite color and my favorite pattern. I don't know. All right, let's try this again. This one air, getting through this one room is a pain in the ass. But then once you're through the room, you're good to go. How's my spooky season been? Any plans? Spooky season overall has been pretty good. I've been keeping busy. But no real definitive Halloween plans. Which that it might be cool if I had some. But I don't. There we go, I got him. No definitive cool Halloween plans. I've thought about it. He goes, ugh. I saw a question mark. I might have a scientist coming in here. Let's pull this guy back a little. That sounds good. Battery. Alright, I'm gonna try to get the scientist dude to come in here. I heard a question mark. Or I saw a question mark. See if I can get scientist dude. Oh, dude, that's a fucking...
What's wrong?
Oh, shit! Got him. Alright, cautions, no big deal. Hold on, there's a scientist around there. Oh, hold on, this could be good. This could be a good thing. Nice! Hey, ho, ho! I need a shit, man. Y'all, I need a costume. Yo, Oni Link! Maybe at least a super macho man. Hey, ho! Although it wouldn't be really fitting with either Resident Evil or Metal Gear. And it would just basically be me in a Speedo. Actually, it would not actually be allowed on Twitch. Did you know on Twitch that guys cannot go shirtless? That it is a violation of their terms of service? Do you know that? Bet you didn't know that. Yep, no Soda Popinski for you. Sorry, Oni Link. Alright, here we go. No more scientists. Yeah. Well, that's the benefits of being a small channel. For all of us. That ain't nobody caring. Shut up, Google. Alright, just looking for stuff. Looking for loot. I like looking for loot. I love running around as a scientist. They have no idea. Even though I love how he still has his bandana, though. Yeah, just always wear at least, like, a tank top. Yeah, you can't go straight up shirtless on Twitch, even if you're a dude. I don't make the rules. I just enforce them. No, I'm just kidding. I don't do that either. Alright, here I have to be careful. Boom. Alright, no alerts, no kills, we're doing well. First thing I'm gonna do, as soon as we get out here, is save.
You wanna
Yeah, I wanna save. On our second file here, whoa. Whoa.
Snake, have you ever seen the guns of Navarone?
No, I haven't.
Never.
It's about a mission to blow up the huge guns on the island of Navarone during World War II.
We'll play a few Kodak calls too.
Participate in the operation, each with his own special ability. They only have until an English destroyer passes by the island to complete their mission. Facing impossible odds, the six men have to sneak onto the island from a cliff on the southern shore.
That doesn't sound like something I'd want to watch in my free time.
Maybe not for you, but the Major was absolutely crazy about it.
Mm.
The Major?
He told me to tell you how great it was.
Tell him I'll go see it as soon as I get back to the States.
That was a quick turnaround.
You want to tell him yourself?
No, let's save that for later. I better get back to the mission.
Yeah.
Snake always getting back to the mission. Alright, I have to figure this out here. First thing I do is I get down low. Oh, shit, hold on. Alright, now that I'm in the green... I gotta put on something green. Flecktarn is really your friend. Flecktarn's your friend. Remember that if you ever play MGS3 on any platform. That Flecktarn. If you wear Flecktarn, you're in for a good tarn. That wasn't even a very good near rhyme. I apologize for that. But the point is, it has a pretty good camo index on anything green or greenish. Look at that guy. He has no idea he's about to go down. Down he goes. Another guy. Look at this gentleman.
What's wrong?
He goes, "What's wrong?" All right, let's give him a little shake. Oh yeah, give me some items. Gimme, gimme. We got a froggy here. Yeah, I see. That's what I do. It's a great game. Oh, it's got a great retro achievement set. I've gotten quite a few on RA. Definitely recommended. Got stuff under here. I've gotten a bunch of those. There's a lot. A lot more than you have in a collection like this. Here you just have the generic achievements or trophies from Blue Point. They're not bad. It's not a bad set, but it's not nearly as in-depth as retro achievements, where they cover everything. Every secret, every bonus extra, everything is on the website. Which is kind of, it's the way it is. It's always like the big major companies always drop the ball. They're always the one that, like, their achievements and trophies are kind of mediocre. And kind of fans at Retro Achievements, they kind of know what we want. Because they're fellow players. They know how to make good sets. Alright, let's give this boy a little shake. What you got? Alright, like to sneak through here. Yeah, the sets for 1, 2, and 3 on that site are all really good. And VR missions and all that stuff. All that good stuff. Alright, got a suppressor. Alright, there's a gentleman right here. This guy's about to take a nap. He just don't know it yet. Alright. I actually want this bird. I think I already have one, but... Got him. I actually have to kill the dog. I hate doing it every time. Oh! Alright, killed the dog. I gotta be careful. I got a good thing going here. Let's not ruin it. Shouldn't be another dog. I want the bird. Alright, let's look through our food. We haven't played this since yesterday, so a lot of stuff's probably spoiled. My Kenyan mangrove crab has gone bad. Everything else is pretty good. Mostly because it's, like, processed food. Birdie. Alright, the sand whistling thrush.
Hey, this works.
Hey-ho. I feel like there's another bird. Hold on, let me pull up my list. I've got a little notepad documents because I'm trying to get every animal. I could be wrong, but I think there was another one. Hold on, let me look around a little bit. Yada, 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 yada. There's a red and granny gorky exterior outside walls. There's a red avidavit. Is this granny gorky outside walls? Lab exterior. This looks like outside walls to me. They seem to be suggesting there's another bird that I don't got yet. I'm going to look around a little bit. I'm playing on hard, so I don't have the sonar or the radar detector. Which maybe would have been a good consideration on my end. Got him. Alright, thermal goggles help. Oh, I see the I see a bird. Look at that. Is that a bird? Maybe not. I think that's just a light. Nah, that was a light showing up. I hear whistling. I caught a bird, but it wasn't the one that I thought I was looking for. Hold on, I see something. It could be the same bird. I hear other birds. I think that's still going to be the same one. I have to use instinct. Alright, yeah. Hey! What's up, Riptide? It's good to see you here, man. It is always good to see an old friend. What's up, Riptide? How you doing? I'm playing some, not Resident Evil. I'm so used to playing Resident Evil here. We're actually taking a Resident Evil break. I'm playing Metal Gear Solid Master Collection. This is Volume 1, which has MGS3. And I'm going for some special trophies. No kills, no alerts. Collect every animal. Like I'm fucking Noah. Yeah. Just lurking around the internet, nice. That sounds like a good Saturday night. You haven't played this game since it came out in PS2. Well, shit. I've always been quite fond of it. There's a bird that I'm looking for. I'm trying to catch every plant and every animal. And while this collection's not perfect, it is nice playing this game at a locked 60 frames per second. And HD and all that jazz. Alright. I hear birds everywhere. I don't have my sonar or anything. So, hold on, whoa. There's a snake, I have to watch out. No 3DS version, what the hell? Here. I just don't want to get shocked by the fence. Fucking around. Kick the snake. Wah! Wah! Boop. Alright. Whoa, he's back up! Our dude is back up. Oh, nice, I got him. That was a pretty good range shot. Not to toot my own horn, but that one worked out pretty good. Alright. Man, I bet you that was the bird. It'll come back. I just have to be careful not for these dudes to wake up. I want that bird. I swear there's a bird right outside these walls that I don't have, that I want, that I need. Okay, hold on. For some reason, the bird seems to be not showing up as, like, red or orange. This could always be a glitch, both between Blue Point and this new collection. Those exist. Oh, hold on. Sometimes you just gotta use your own eyes. Wonder if the night vision goggles would help. Most definitely not. I'm gonna use stalking mode. And I'm gonna break out the thermal goggles. I don't have a sonar, I don't have a radar. I'm just walking carefully. I gotta kinda keep my eyes peeled. Just looking for a bird. You can strafe a little bit. You can get on your tiptoes. I hear birds singing. A good giveaway is when they're moving the grass around. Oh, God. That dude's up. That guy's awake. There we go. Used up that suppressor. I'm playing on hard, and so they don't fall. They're not asleep forever when you knock them out. Hold on. I see the bird. It's a small one, but I see it. Right here. Got it! Hold on. We gotta eat something. Let's eat our milk snake.
I've had enough.
Yeah, he doesn't like the milk snake. Bird C. I think I was missing this one. Yeah, there it is. Red Affidavit. I did not have that one. Alright, now we can move on. Now we're going to be fighting our good friend, the Fear. If we're going to be doing this, let's do it right. I'm going to use Infinity Face Paint, because this is a new game plus. I'm not going for... I don't have any special items restrictions. I'm going to use my sneaking suit, which will have any damage. Speed up recovery. There's an interesting trick. There's kind of a glitch you can do that I'm going to try to exploit, if I can pull it off, with... any kind of machine gun really will work. I'm thinking like I gotta unequip some stuff. Don't need the grenades right now. Let's break out this one right here. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, I'm not making it easy on myself here. Even with the bonus items. I don't have stealth camo, so it's not like I've got all the best of the best. Alright, this is not a story playthrough. I've done many of those before on Gaming with Drew. Snake got hit. We're gonna go ahead and skip this. We will do some funny codec calls here and there. Alright, I need serum. And let's remove this. Alright, very good. So what I do... as I put this on, no need to use suppressors and wear them out. Use my Mark 22. No kills, no alerts means this counts for bosses too. I can't kill any bosses. I have to just knock them out. I already got the flying squirrel in this area. Then we'll have to get the Tsuchinoko. Rare enemy. Now, he's going to go after food pretty soon. We can throw poison out for him. Sometimes he'll even eat poison on his own like an idiot. But who knows? Sometimes I just get on a groove like this. Where'd he go? Oh, shit. Where is he? No! Bastard. That sucked. I had him down to the wire. And he fucking... You saw that. You were looking at his stamina bar. He was almost done. I will. I would say I did. What else you got? I like his. Ooh, alright, here we go. What does? Oh, shit, hold on. Alright, hold on. Watch this. I'm gonna try to do the trick. Hit him with. You throw a stun grenade. I have to be quick. Now he gets stunned. You hear him say, my eyes. Now I'm gonna use a lethal weapon. This is a fucking machine gun. Look at his stamina. Look at his stamina bar go. It's gone now, but for some reason when he's stunned by the stun grenade, I think this has been a glitch since the original game. I don't think it's intended. But if you stun him... if you stun him, then machine guns... God damn, I keep fucking this up. I'll tell you what. Try to get these out. Try to get him to pick those up. Those will put him to sleep. It'll make him sick, I'm quite sure. A lot of tricks for these fights. Nice! I got him. I got that poison mushroom out. Couldn't resist it. Where is he? There he is. We got another poison. You got them both. Got him! Both, that's crazy. Both poison mushrooms that I put out for him, he ate. That's amazing. And thankfully I had already, exactly. Yeah, exactly. That's how I feel about this game. As much as I love the bunny, I don't want to hurt the bunny. The bunny does give me serum. Alright, now, this is a part with a very hidden item. And if you're a casual player of this game, casual, I don't know how casual you are with this game, but there's some really neat stuff, and there's a super secret animal that you can only find here. You need mouse traps for it. And here's the fastest way to do it. Put out a bunch of mouse traps. I have infinity face paint, so I can just put out as many as I want. Oh, you platinumed HD collection in 5 days. Whoa, okay. So you know some shit. Now you can leave this area. Okay, very good. I still haven't platinumed the PS3 version. I never got all the frogs. I always found that annoying, especially on like the bike sequences. Frog. Alright, cage full. Let's see what we have in my cages. I already got the snake thing, so we don't need those anymore. We can go ahead and dispose those. I don't need a poison dart frog. Okay. I guess I'm the real casual. Frog C, frog C. Don't need frog C. Frog C, yeah. The ladder boss fight. That's what people call it. Alright, we're gonna leave the mouse traps out. Run back this way. We gotta get the Tsuchinoko. Even though I've already beaten it with it, I gotta get every animal and every plant in one playthrough. Here we go. Alright, a bunch of new stuff. You'll get those poison dart frogs a lot. And we don't want them. We certainly don't want to eat them. Let's eat this red Avadavat. Hold on, I gotta know how this is said. I'm calling paramedic. She'll know how it's said. She'll tell me about it.
I see you've caught yourself a red Avadavat.
Avadavat.
The red Avadavat is a small bird native to southern China and Southeast Asia. This is its mating season, so the males ought to be a brilliant red color right now. If you want to catch one alive, use the tranquilizer gun. By catching one and then releasing it, you might be able to distract the enemy's attention.
Yo.
I see. How do they taste?
The what?
The flavor.
You're not going to eat such a cute little bird, are you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Something bothering you?
I love this. No. Yeah.
Okay then, so how about it?
How should I know?
Oh man, she was not impressed. Well, find out.
No good.
No good. Now, sometimes this game can be crazy. Sometimes you call her back. He's like, hey, I tried it. It was awful.
I see you found some fly agaric mushrooms. The fly agaric is a relative of the death cap mushroom that grows only in that region. You'll find it growing on the ground, but it's poisonous. So if you pick one up, don't eat it. If you do eat one, go into the survival viewer immediately and use cure to take some
antidote. Why would I eat one after you told me not to?
The poisons found in the fly agaric include phallotoxins and amatoxins. It says here that when you eat it...
All right. Let's try to catch some more stuff with my mouse traps. All right, here we go. Everything all spun around. Lay out a bunch of them. A lot of times putting them around the swamp is a good idea. Sometimes you can even see it. You can even see the Tsuchinoko. It's like a big slug. You can see it if you look close enough. Here we go. Sometimes another fast way I've noticed is when I plant them, if I kind of walk off, you'll hear a bunch of them go off, kind of when you're out of range. I don't know exactly how it works. Here. Let's get the life medicine's full. Okay, that's good. Let me get out my thermal goggles so I can see stuff. European Extreme. Oh shit. I've never fucked with that. I have played it on Extreme before, but I've never played it on European Extreme. Any of the games for that matter. Frog. 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 Alright. Dispose of all of them. We ain't looking for a frog. No frog. I want to make absolutely certain that I... Here, hold on. Let's get that. Let's get that. Alright. Just want to make sure I get... We gotta make sure with Markor that you get everything. I want the dirty magazine, damn it. I've gotten the Loco, Yamokos, whatever they're called here. Let's go start going through this stuff. We really don't need, like, all these Russian rations.
Disgusting.
We don't need the poison dart frog. We don't need the Golova. These recharge your battery, which is why I'm hanging on to them, but I really don't need them. Fly Agaric. Okay, I wanted to make sure. I wanted to reach. Got the bird. Got the fruit. Whoop! Alright. I'm gonna switch areas, come back, and we gotta get that Tsuchinoko. Now I should hear a bunch of boing, 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 boing. If not, I think you do maybe at some point have to replant the mouse traps. I'm not certain on that, but they didn't seem to go off. So let's try that. It could be that I'm also planting too many. Like in the game, without the Infinity face paint, you never get a million. You usually get like between 4 and 6 tops. I'm gonna plant like 1, 2, 3. Some of the birds I noticed show up as blue. Oh, that's not a bird. Look at that. That looked like the silhouette of a bird from where I'm standing. Look at that. And that other bird didn't show up very, very clearly, so. Could see where I thought that. Alright. Now I'm gonna go this way and I'm gonna hope that I don't just get 4 poison dart frogs. Frog. Frog. Tsuchinoko! We got it. Alright. So, let's go into our food. Dispose, dispose, and we're gonna keep the Tsuchinoko. We don't need anything else. And now, we can call paramedic. And celebrate.
Snake, you caught a Tsuchinoko.
What? Is it true, Snake?
Yeah.
Way to go, my man! You really are the boss's apprentice.
Yes, it looks like sending you in was worth it after all. Hurry up and finish your mission and then bring it back to us. Under no circumstances are you to eat it, is that clear?
Yeah. All right. All right, we're going back into... Whoops. We're going back. No, I want to bring it back. I don't want to eat it. I don't like eating the Tsuchinoko. It's too cute. How could you want to eat it? I know I already have the Infinity face paint, so I guess I'm already have that locked on this file. I've already caught it now. I suppose I could. Let's do a save. We have no alerts, no kills. Let's keep the save. You can do as many saves as we want. Let's keep these going. Thankfully, they save nice and fast on the solid state drive. Have you seen They're the two biggest things that I will give this release of you know, Master Collection by Konami. The two biggest things I'll give it are frame rate and loading times. There's a lot more they could have done. This isn't perfect. There's a lot of, you can find criticisms all over the internet. But, oh shit. Okay, hold on. There's a dude down there.
What's wrong?
I like the what's wrong. But frame rate and loading times. On those two marks, it gets an A+. Okay, hold on.
Bing, boom, boom, boom.
Here he is.
What's wrong?
Yeah! Dude. That worked out beautifully. I loved that. And you can shoot him in the butt. The tranquilizer dart. Dude, someone clip that, please. I was trying to get that fool, and I just dropped on him. More mouse traps. More medical supplies. More suppressors. We're gonna tear this game apart. Yeah. We're doing well.
Boom, 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 boom.
Oh, bandage. All right. Get these. Don't forget those. Now we have a key to this door. Now we can go this way. And we're going to switch back into our trusty Flecktarn. A good all-purpose outdoor camo. Okay. I hear stuff. First things, get the plants. Alright, very nice. Medical supplies. Oh, we got a call! We got a call! Alright, it's Eva.
Snake. Are you there?
Thank you.
Eva.
Casual, appreciate it. Oh, thank you, Oni Link. We got double. Who's gonna have the better clip? We're gonna have a little competition, it seems. Food full. What food is this? Let's eat the magpie. Ugh. Snake's gonna be fat when he gets back. Mushroom F. Which mushroom is that? Oh, that one. Ugh. Snake would say. Alright, we're gonna get this. Antidote. Let's make sure. We gotta clear some room, guys. We gotta clear some room. I don't need all of these. I don't need all my batteries perfect. I don't need all these calorie mates. I don't need the fly agaric. I don't need all these instant noodles and calorie mates. I know they're good. I don't need this Yabloko Maloko.
What is this?
Yeah, I don't need this. Alright, I need some room. Mushroom G. I need dirty magazines. I need the splint. I hate to do it, but I need to kick the bunny rabbit. Kick the damn rabbit, like Michelangelo says. Get my serum. Alright, you can get a lot of medical supplies out here. Just making sure. Some things I might accidentally double up on, but... It is what it is. Disinfectant. Gimme. I bet a lot of first-time players never knew you could, like, kick all these plants and get all these medical supplies. Well, now you know. Who knew you got serum from bunny rabbits? I assume there's some more grain of truth to that. Alright. This looks delicious. Oh, never mind. Looks good to me. What do I know? Oh, there's melons here. I don't mean the kind from Austin Powers. Our vegetable is what they call it. Okay. Oh, it's horrible. It was 85 here today, Oni Link. I mowed my front and back lawn and got like sunburned, and it was hot. And I was wondering, what the fuck? Vine melon, I want to eat this. I like the... Mm. Hold on. I see a bird. Just being thorough. Some of these are going to be doubles. But I want it all. Oh, man. That rip. I'm totally jealous. I'm jealous of you, too. Yeah, the South sucks. Alright. There's gonna be some unique foods in the next area. We're definitely gonna get a save going. We're definitely gonna save here. This is a very camouflagey area. And what I mean is, there's a lot of soldiers sneaking around. There's a lot of different earthy colors in this area. It's easy for you to get spotted. It's easy for you to, if you play your cards right, to sneak up on someone. It's good to use your AP sensor here. I was reading my guide. I've got it up right here. And there is going to be a unique... Here, hold on. I've got it pulled up right here. There's going to be a unique mushroom in this area. So we got to be careful. I also have to get the Inn's parrot. It's going to be a unique mushroom. Hold on. Let me read... Whoops, wrong button. Sorry. Let me reread the map. Something west. Yeah, this is the area. This area has a unique mushroom. So we have to look around for it. While not getting spotted. Or falling into a trap. This really is where the thermal goggles do come in handy. Hold on, is that it? This might be it. I think that's it. Let me throw away... Let me eat this tree frog. It's kind of a cute froggy. I'm going to throw away this apple. I'm going to throw away the magpie. I'm going to throw away the coral snake. I'm going to throw away the things he doesn't like. Hey! Fungus Among Us! We got every type of mushroom. We're doing well. Alright, we got every type of mushroom. We poisoned a guard. We're tearing through. All we got left. We got to do these this playthrough. These aren't too hard. I looked them up. There's only 5 of them. Find all 64 keratins. That's going to be a playthrough for another time. Collect every type of bird. I think the only one I'm missing is the Inn's parrot. If I'm lucky. Every type of snake. There's going to be 3 during the boss fight where you actually literally find solid liquid and solidus snake in the form of these pure kind of white snakes. And getting all of that will get me the title of Markor. By me not getting spotted, I'll get the stealth camo. By me finish the game without killing anyone, I'm going for that. Clear the game without entering alert mode, except when it's mandatory, I'm going for that too. Earn the title of Foxhound. That one I won't be getting this playthrough. So the 64 keratins and the title of Foxhound are the 2 that I won't be able to get this playthrough. Everything else I'm going for. Now, hold on, I see... Oh god, I'm standing right on a trap. Alright, hold on, I gotta be careful. Whoa, someone saw me. I'm running. He's just seeing things. Alright, gotta be very careful. Hornet's nests give me ointment. Alright, I'm gonna try crawling a little bit. I know I'm being cautious, but... There's dudes around this neck of the woods. I am gonna go to the optional area just because I can. There he is. Oh, I want to shoot him right in between the trees. Got him. Still gonna be more. You worry not, there will be more. Nothing in the log. I think we have every bird. Alright, there's gonna be dudes over here. Whoop! I love a lot of the basic play mechanics of this game, like kind of sidling up against something and peering around the corner and then being able to sort of like manipulate the camera. It's It's a good game, man. There are antiquated things. Like, either shooting from either, like, a toe-to-toe position or first person. There's no, like, third person shooting. But there's a lot that's fun in this game. And there's a lot that has aged well. Whoa! That scared the crap out of me. Oh, did you guys hear that sound I made? Whew, that might be clip-worthy, I don't know. Alright, let's definitely get a save going. Like I said, we're trying to be better safe than sorry. I am saving the game.
Snake, have you seen the
No, I haven't. I'm wondering if I should wait. Oh! I know it can look good on PCSX2 upscale, but I never tried it with the 60fps patch. Does that interfere with achievements? Because if not, then I might have to try that. That I never tried. I just grinned and bared it and played it at 30. Oh, they don't like... Ooh, he's coming my way. No. Ooh, no. I thought he'd run the other way. Oh, no. Desert Tiger. It's put me up to net 95%. Oh, I might have to mess with that. Let's see if I can get him with the cigarette spray. Ah! That's okay. I can reload it. I should have done that. All right. Because we have to reload it anyway... I'm gonna do something kind of fun. They're knocked out. They didn't call in for help. This is something I always thought was a cool thing. This was demoed in one of the very early teaser trailers for this game. That's how nifty they thought this upcoming thing was. All right, so we're gonna switch. I'm gonna have to reload this in a moment, but we're gonna switch me back to Flecktarn. I'm gonna go in my backpack, and I'm gonna break out my sniper rifle. They advertised this shit in the early trailers, like in 2003 teasers. This is pre-YouTube. This is stuff that you would watch on, like, GameSpot.com.
HQ respond. This is HQ.
Do I see a dude?
Patrol here.
What's going on? Respond. Got him. Very cool.
There's something wrong. Support unit, confirm their status.
Like, just being able to climb up that tree and snipe that fucking cabin. Considering, like, the limitations of PlayStation 2, I just think that's a really cool feature, a really cool area. Alright, let's return to title screen. We'll load this back up. Again, we're going for no alerts, no kills. But yeah, I'll have to look at that and I'll have to try that next time I go achievement hunting on that version of the game. I still have plenty more I have to get. I'm sure you can look up my profile and see what I got. I got quite a bit, but there's always more. Yeah. There it is. All right, we're gonna crawl. It might be. Well, it might be because it also includes Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2, which I saw some people complaining about, but I think is perfectly fine. My philosophy on retro achievements is, like, the more the merrier, because why not? Shit. They might send some people out. One of the ways I feel about retro achievements, though, is kind of the philosophy of why not. Like, it's something that's done by fans to be cool and to be fun. It's not done by, like, a company to fall to any kind of rigid rules or anything. So, like, if you ask me, like, they obviously have a set for Super Mario World. I think it'd be perfectly fine if they made a set for Mario World plus Lost Levels and just made them different. Different stuff. And my justification would be, because why not? Alright, here we go. Just make them different. Don't recycle the same ones. Just make them different. Those are fun games.
What's wrong?
Alright, hold on. Oh! I hear someone. I hear someone not happy. This guy. He's not happy. Ooh! Oh! Alright, we're good. I still need to be careful. I'm still being a little brazen. Like, watch me. Oh! There's still a dude around here. I need to be careful. Sneaking around. TNT full. I need to get more, Ooh, can I see him through here? Oh, that's what I need. I need that ammo. If he comes this way, I can get him. There he is! Yeah! Good shit. Alright, I'll take that ammo. I'll take all this ammo, if I can. Alright, there's a new gun over here. It's the whole reason I came out here. I didn't need to come to this area. I have all the animals. And I don't even need this weapon, I just want it. Look at that. M63 American Light Machine Gun. This is the total Rambo gun of the game. If there's any gun where you can completely go Rambo, it is this one. There, I see a dude. Wow. I got a pretty easy 50-pointer the other day for getting one of the other endings for Resident Evil 3 Nemesis. I was kind of surprised. I mean, I had a save file near the end, and the ending I achieved wasn't that different from the one that I had already gotten in terms of what I had to do. I just made a different decision, and I got a 50-pointer. That's what helped get me in the top 600. Let me eat something. Here, let's eat this new mushroom. Ooh! I didn't know that one was poisonous. Shit. Use the antidote. Whoops. Well, now I know. The more you know. Alright. I'm gonna get this one for the ointment. Ow. Ow. Let me put on Hornets. I fucked this up. I put on the Hornet camo. They won't mess with me. Which is still a pretty good camo index. There, go away. Alright, let's switch back to Flecktarn. Let's take, it always helps me here. This is kind of, this area is kind of mazy. We want to go north, not east. Which means I think I'm moving in the right way. Yeah, let's keep going this way. I think the only bird I have left is the Inn's parrot. Which I might need some help with. I don't remember exactly. Here we go. That's where we're heading. Alright. One of the best ways to do this. I used to be a little bit too... Like, I just go running out. Look, like, I wouldn't approach this with enough strategy. Woodland's definitely going to be best. I'm even going to go ahead and start crawling. This area, there's a lot of moss areas that will bring you up to a camo index of 100. This is the Inn's camo that I'm wearing right now. I'm going to switch to thermal goggles. And I actually think, if I remember right, let me get out my scope. I think the Inn's bird will sometimes hang out on here. Could be wrong. I think it might change based on difficulty. The Inn's parrot, I'm going to have to find. If anyone wants to look up, casual, if you want to help me out, if you could look up the Inn's parrot on hard. There, I'm at 100%. The Inn's parrot, because I think it changes based on difficulty, if I recall correctly. Because sometimes I know the Inn's parrot will chill right up here, and will kind of play the role as the spotter for the Inn. But I gotta have that parrot to get every bird. Just checking now, sweet. Yeah, just specify the difficulty. Hard, the Inn's parrot. I wanna say it differs. I've got a good camo index going. If I can get eyes on the Inn. Oh, I think I do. I think that's him right there. I can't do thermal... Yeah, I think that's him up there. I can't do thermal goggles and... I can't do thermal goggles. There he is. I see him. I can't do thermal goggles and scope. That's what I'm trying to say. Whoop. Let's see if there's something better I can use. I'm going to try to be really sneaky in this area. Flectarn, DPM. Brings me up to 95. The parrot is usually on that ammo building first. Yeah, that's what I thought. And it might still be just at an angle that I'm not seeing. I'm moving slowly and quietly. I just don't want him to see me. Yeah. I know where he is. But I know the bird... I'm going to try going around. I am going to be a little slow and steady with this one. We could always be cheap and save the game and set the clock forward a week. But I'm not doing that. What is this? Oh, it's just a rabbit. Okay. It could be that if I step further away and kind of go around from a different angle, that the bird will then jump up on there. I see him. Look at him. You can see the his scope. I'm going to get it max. Let's put on moss. Look at this. This will put us at 100%. If I move slow enough, it'll stay at 100%. I'm gonna see if I can get that bird. Here we go. Alright, that's a good view of the top. That's a good view. Whoop, whoop, whoop. That's a good... This is a good view of the top of this. Let's grab the scope. It's not there. Now, maybe it will move back here at some point, but it's not there right now. The end is right up here. Sometimes it's... What? He saw the scope. He saw my scope. Oh, that bastard.
That's damn good.
Now he shoots darts at you. So he doesn't kill you. I can't believe that. Oh. And you just gotta take him out with your knife. Oh, jeez. You gotta be careful not to let him knock you out. You'll wake up in a prison cell. I gotta eat something. Calorie Mate. I looked up Calorie Mate because I was really curious. It's a real thing. They're incredibly unhealthy. I looked at the Calorie Mate block. Hold on, let's see if I can spin it around. So it's called Calorie Mate because it perfectly balances out the calories. Wow, it's blurry, but you can kind of read even from here. Yeah, a serving is 400 calories, and they use this because you can easily balance out, but of those calories, it's mostly fat and sugar, very little fiber, only 5 grams of protein, and relatively low in any sort of vitamins or minerals. The reason it's just fat and it's just like saturated fat and sugar. It's mostly sugar, 40 grams of sugar. It's chocolate bars. It's a candy. But there are people that actually apparently tried to use them to lose weight because they help you manage your calorie intake. But it's like, yeah, if you just eat 2 of those a day and you're only getting 800 calories a day, then you're just going to starve yourself. But you're starving yourself with nothing but sugar. Yeah. Alright, hold on. It's like you're just doing a crash diet by just eating sugar. Not a good plan. All right, I need plan B on the end's parrot. I'm getting that bird. I am getting that bird. I want... Whoa. Yeah, I agree. Hold on, where is he? No, you bastard. I think it's only hard in the sense of, like, getting used to that routine, sticking with it. Having willpower, that's kind of the hard part for a lot of people.
I want some more.
You know, abstaining from things that are calorie dense, like alcohol. Alright, hold on. Where is he? I want to find this bastard bird. I need that bird. Yeah, portion control is a big thing. That's usually, like, where doctors will tell you to focus. By the way, I can never tell, but I feel like the rain looks kind of glitchy in the Master Collection version. I don't have the PS2 version original in front of me, but it doesn't look right to me. Wow, you wake up and you're not hungry for at least 48 hours. That's 4 to 8 hours. That's crazy. I definitely can't relate to that. I the first thing I do when I get up is I have to take my thyroid med. After that, I can't eat for 30 minutes. But as soon as the 30 minutes are up, I eat. And I'm usually not like starving, but I'm ready to eat. Like, I wouldn't want to go any longer than 45 minutes without eating. But yeah, I swear this, like, rain effect does not look right. I'm pretty sure this is a Master Collection glitch, if it wasn't a Blue Point glitch. This unfortunately shares the distinction of being a port of a port. Where's that damn bird? It ain't up here. I'm trying to move slowly. Because I've definitely seen the bird up there before. It's just he's not showing up. He's being an ass. Where are you, old man? Alright. I have to get this bird to get this rank. So the bird is a non-negotiable. Check the trees with the thermal is the advice you're seeing online. Okay. Now, it could be any trees. Wait. Hold on. It's kind of hard to tell sometimes. Because I think he will kind of appear anywhere. Yeah, you might be right. Because I'm getting deja vu too. Because I remember it taking me a while to figure it out. Then I finally found that damn bird, and all was well in the world. You might have. That'd be funny if you, like, look through. Although it doesn't save VODs all that long anymore. It's probably not there. It's so funny. As we get old, we just get old shitty memories. Like something we did 4 months ago. It's like, oh yeah, I think we did do that. Doing the same thing. Literally hunting for achievements / trophies in MGS3. There's the frog. Whoa, I'm going a little crazy here, a snake. Oh, it's clearing up. Will bird go back? Hey, rabbit. Alright, we're gonna look around. We're gonna find this damn bird. First, I'm gonna refill my coffee. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna put the Be Right Back screen up. I'm gonna run a couple ads. And I am going to grab some coffee. I'll be right back.
Thank you.
All right, I'm back. Thank you guys for waiting. I appreciate it. Oh, let me get my controller back. Took a little break. I ate a little bit of split pea soup. And now I refilled my coffee, which I'm trying not to spill everywhere. I had to do the whole thing where you got the coffee dripping down one side and you got to like quickly lap it up to avoid it landing on your carpet and ruining everything that matters in this world. No, I'm just kidding. What matters is finding that stupid bird. The Inn's parrot. Look at all this mist. That's a lot of mist. Socrovenal. All right. Yeah, this could be tricky. Alright, I already got all them fruits. I think. Let me make sure. Although I have two different playthroughs, so it's always possible I got all the fruits in the last playthrough and I'm missing a fruit here. I had the fungus. Do I have all the fruits? I do. Collect every type of fruit. But that doesn't mean I have them in this playthrough, but I think that I do. Ain't worried about fruits. I'm worried about that stupid parrot. Every time I see something light up orange, I'm gonna kinda give a clicky click. Cause I don't think it's either of these birds. Yeah, it's not those. Let me look at my backpack real quick. Pull out things I don't need. I don't think that the Inn's parrot is going to go for any of the mouse traps. Not 100% sure. I could try. I do have Infinity Face Paint. Let's go to Camouflage, Face. Infinity does drop you down in terms of Camo Index. Whoa, I see a bird. I just feel like all these birds are not the bird. I think when I get his bird, if and when I get his bird, I think he's gonna be pissed. It doesn't really matter if I kill it or catch it. I mean, it'll matter to the end. Doesn't matter to me. Bird D, that's the magpie. Bird D. Alright. Magpie, I'll dispose of it. Magpie, let's eat one. I don't think Snake likes them too much. Yeah, let's just throw the other one away. I'm gonna keep crawling. Maybe I should leave some mouse traps out. I just collected my own damn trap. I have to be careful because I'm crawling. Hear something. Okay. The end. We'll find them. Leave some traps. Leave some cheese. Use our thermal goggles and look to the trees. Let's take a look here. This isn't going to be easy. Unless it just all of a sudden gets easy. As soon as I get the bird, I'm not worried about the end. The end is like, once you get on a routine with them, you can beat them pretty fast. I think these are all just magpies. Whoa. Will it tell you in the scope if you... Doesn't really tell you with any buttons. It's too bad. Alright, let's not be spinning ourselves to death here, Snake. Have I ever seen the training videos for new Waffle House employees? Hold on. The way they use forks, napkins, condiment packets to tell the cooks what people want is insane. No, but you have me incredibly curious. Is there one in particular? Like, send me the video on Discord. You have me extremely curious. I like weird stuff like that. No way he's gonna see me. Whoop. Now he might. Hold on. Let's try the AP sensor. Yeah, I like weird stuff like that. I used to work at a Five Guys, and I had to watch a training video from the CEO himself, and he was a very colorful character. Yeah, I remember it vividly. He was like, "You can never give the customer too many fries." That was his philosophy. I remember I got to watch the video at home. Like, I got paid to just watch the stupid videos at home. And my friend was sitting there watching it with me. And he turns to me, he's like, "I agree." Yeah, it's a good philosophy. My friend goes, "I agree." And he says it like, I don't know, he had like a New York or a New Jersey accent. And he was really passionate about it. He was like, oh, "You can never give the customer too many fries." Oh, it was great. "You can never give the customer too many fries." It's like, no such thing. Alright, Markor, that's the rank I'm going for. See what the paramedic has to say about this beautiful, beautiful animal.
If he shoots you,
sweet.
If you run out of stamina.
All right, let's get to the animals.
When you have a snake. Snake.
I feel like when you Tatsu or whatever his name was from Turtles 1. I want to hear about my new animal. Oh, you can never give the customer too many fries. That just, like, really stood out to me. Made an impression on me. I don't think he's wrong. It's good philosophy. What is this? I keep seeing stuff, and then it's just like, oh, it's a mushroom. He's gonna see me. It's a mushroom. Whoa. Whoa. Alright. I just want to catch that goddamn parrot. Everything else I don't care about. Rabbit. Rabbit. I'll eat a rabbit. 24-hour parrot stream. Well, we have to keep going until we get the parrot. Parrot's a bird. Whoa. No. Okay. I'm gonna check a spot. Sometimes you can get a little beep if you're going the right way. Still got. Whoa! Oh, there goes my links. Nice. I forgot to silence my phone. Whatever. There's only one thing I know for sure in this world anymore, to everything I've been through, and that's that you could never give the customer too many fries. That's mean, Oni Link. I'm trying. Splints. Alright, I think I can see the warehouse from here. Let me get out my scope. There's a snake. Hold on. It's possible that's a snake I don't have. Alright, so I'm gonna keep an eye on that. No! How am I seeing from his perspective? How is this happening? Whoa! What is going on? How was that happening? I don't know if that was a glitch or a feature. We'll have to ask Todd Howard what he thinks. Now that I did on purpose, believe it or not, because I just got a bunch of splints. And this will extend my max health. I'm serious. But that was crazy. Oh man, really? I want that stupid parrot. And I'll do anything till I have it. Alright, I'm going to switch face paints to... Let's switch this. Let's switch face paint to woodland. I don't want this guy to see me. I just want to see his bird. I'm going to move slowly and quietly. I can't look at him with the binoculars. He'll see it glint. Yes. I'll see his bird. It's the only bird that I need left. And then I can die satisfied. I'm running for it. Oh, for nothing. I wonder if I can climb on top of this building and leave. Hold on. I'm gonna leave some mouse traps. It's maybe a long shot. Let's put the infinity face paint back on. Let's get real visible. Stop. I'm catching this bird. Now I'm gonna go this way. I'm up for the end bird catching tips, if anyone has any. I'm gonna catch this bird if it's the last thing I do. Did I ever catch that? I never grabbed that snake, by the way. Which I think I already had, but... is that actually true? Wait. I hate it when I think I see a bird, and it's like, oh, nope, it's just a mushroom. Don't you hate that in life? Take that. The crab. I want this stupid bird. Which movie was that? I don't remember that. I'm hit or miss with my Adam Sandler movies. I only really like the classics, like Happy Gilmore and Billy Madison and stuff like that. I feel like it didn't take Adam Sandler long to start doing bad movies. Not that the former movies were any kind of masterpieces. But you know what I mean. Bird D, these are just magpies. Ugh, poison dart frog, giant anaconda was tasty, markhor tasted great, vine melon was pretty tasty. Let's eat another one. A Siberian ink cap. Alright. We're saving the Tsuchinoko. When I hear that sound, I always feel like it's the end breathing. Which I think it kind of is. What happens if I shoot these? I think those might be medical supplies. Or mushrooms. 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 God damn it. This fight's starting to piss me off. I just want the end stupid parrot. Okay. I want to make sure I'm clear on this point. And then he's already down to half his health. He just slowly starts dying. He sucks. Man. Hey, hold on. Mushroom. Splint. Splint. Let's see if there's another one of those. Yeah. I want to make sure I actually get this snake. Oh, no, you don't. No. Oh, look at that. This apparently is a thing. Stop shooting me. Alright, hold on. Boom. Boom. Get some grub in us. Yeah, I had totally forgotten about that. I've had enough. No, you want more, Snake. I've had enough. No, you want some more.
No good.
No, you think you want a magpie.
What is this?
Alright. Hold on. I'm gonna try to get him with. Ow. Oh! Alright, hold on. I'm gonna get this old man. I got something. I heard a sound. Vine melon.
Pretty tasty.
All right. I'm going to jump down. Whoa. I'm gonna grab that. Ow! I'm gonna try to grab that snake I shot down earlier. Where is it? I know I shot down a snake. I've done it twice now. Hold on. There it is. No, that's a mushroom. Does it just disappear fast? Hold on. Did I miss it? Hold on. There it is. There it is. I want it. Just in case I haven't gotten the snake. Snake F. Green. Okay, I've had this one. Just want to make sure.
What can I say?
Want to make sure. All right. Okay. Are any of these the bird? Is that the bird? I doubt it. Probably taken off by now. All I want is the bird. Okay. Well, let's see what we got here. Bird. Snake F. Interesting. Green tree python. All right, magpie we don't need. Green tree python we don't need. We have to keep the Tsuchinoko. Remember not to throw it away. We don't really need it anymore, but I just want it. It's rare. Ow. Bird D. I'm pissed off. Because I don't know how to find this stupid bird.
No good.
I want the bird. Everybody's heard about the bird. Bird's the word. All right, hold on. Where do you shoot from? Where are you shooting from, end? He's like, excuse me, it's the end. I actually see him. You'd help, but you only know where it perches in easier difficulties, and you can't find much online. That sucks. You would think there'd be someone that's like, on hard mode, he's always in... Oh, dude, my hair was styling in that clip. I don't even know what clip that is. Post that clip on my Discord. Was it from this stream? Like, did I have a styling moment in this stream, or was this an old stream? Ow. Back on gaming. Oh, ho, we talking back on gaming. Ancient history, my friend.
That's damn good.
Okay. Back on gaming. Here was styling, huh? You have me curious which clip that is. I would load it up, but my computer could crash. Rabbit. Alright, I'm gonna find this bastard. Yeah. I still haven't gotten that issue resolved, and my computer dude just, like, stopped getting back to me. And it was like, whoa!
The binoculars and first-person...
Oh, this is like the you suck call.
...in detecting the enemy's presence. You should also be making use of your motion detector. Active sonar...
Yeah, I don't have those on hard. Sensor. I have anti-personnel sensor.
You might also try using the directional microphone.
Well, that might help me with the bird. All right. Thank you, Major. I should be appreciative of his advice instead of just talking smack. I don't want to make this run. Whoa! Bird A? Yeah! Dude! We got it!
Flawless victory.
Hello? Hello? Anybody home? Hey! Think with flying thing.
Oh, I got it. Now, it did not pop and be like, oh, you got every bird. Which does kind of make me wonder. Makes me wonder some things. Still up here. Makes me wonder, what bird am I missing? If anyone wants to be a Giga Chad, just look up list of birds on Snake Eater. That's only if you want to be a Giga Chad. You're all Chads, don't get me wrong. Because I'm trying to think of what birds I could be missing. The vulture. No, I know. I you don't have to look it up. You don't. Never mind. It's the vulture, which I haven't come to the mountain yet. But that's the next area. I think I just need to get the vulture, and then I'm good. Because I was trying to. I thought to myself for a second after I caught the inn's parrot. I was like, wait a minute. I still don't have every bird. And then I realized the vulture. And beyond the vulture, I think I'm good. I think that'll be every bird. And then every snake, I think I just need to catch the snakes at the end. Solids, liquid, solidus. Is he still here? Oh, he's still here. Hold on, I'm going to camo up. I'm not taking any chances around here. Woodland, I know I'm sneaking up on him, but I'm not playing around with him anymore. It's raining, so I'm going to put on raindrop. I'm not playing around with him anymore. No more play. I'm taking off the suppressor. That's how much I mean business. Let's make sure which way he's facing. He will turn around periodically. We're going to enter stalking mode. Look at this. Look at him.
Freeze. Huh? Where did you...
Yeah-ha-ha. This is how you get his camo. You have to make him shake 3 times.
I don't think so.
But I already have his camo. Now from here, this is what I said earlier, this gets easy. What I mean is, from here, you can throw on thermal goggles and you can follow his footsteps and you can just get right behind him. Sometimes you can even get a few shots in. Now I can follow his footsteps and know exactly where he is and beat him pretty quick. Watch this. Footsteps. Right here. And he only has certain areas that he will go. You do have to be careful, because you might all of a sudden be like, there you are, boom. But other times, he's a dumbass. It's hard to see the footprints around here. He says there. See, he does that sometimes. We just have to be careful. Yeah, I said it could happen. I'll tell you what, End. How about I eat your parrot? It's not good. It wasn't even good. Your parrot wasn't even good. That's quite a diss. I ate your parrot at the end, and it was fucking gross. Oh, you think you're good? Oh. Hold on. We're taking them on. We're taking them on from a distance. I don't even care. Food. Instant noodles.
I want some more.
Hold on. God damn it, I'm trying to get him. Trying to get him from this distance. Well, I think there's a bunch of achievements for retro achievements in terms of catching the End's parrot, killing it, letting it go, throwing it back at him. Retro achievements goes a lot more above and beyond than what a dev normally does. There he goes. There he is. Oh, come on. There he is. He didn't like that. Sometimes you can get him just like this. Sometimes you can be all like... Oh, I got him! Wow! That's tricky to do, but it can be done. Oh, I know where he's going. I see him already. Let me get all disguised. We're getting ready to take him down for good. Let's see about Moss. Moss is pretty good here. Do I have anything better? No. Oh, I do. 100%. Can't beat 100%. Can't beat 100%. Oh, he's still alive. Holy shit, I gotta be careful. Oh, I have one bullet left. Hold on, I have one bullet left. I have to switch to Infinity Face Paint. Whoops, face. Alright, here we go. Oh, it's crazy. It remembers. Hold on. Shit. Got him! Now, even for New Game Plus, there's a benefit to doing this, which is that you, I already have his camo, but by doing that, you get his sniper rifle. The Mosin Nagant. I don't know how to say that exactly. But with the sniper rifle, it's a tranquilizer sniper rifle. It's like the PSG-1T from 2. Alright. Just getting a little grub. Yeah. All the other bosses, once you have their camos, if you're not going in for anything special, you can just kill them. If you want. But you still get a, there's still benefit to taking on the end the way that I did. Whoop! Alright, there's going to be, in this next area, an Emperor, Scorpion, and a Vulture. I'm gonna put on Animals. Animals is a good desert. I'm getting my desert gear ready. Oh yeah, we got the ladder boss fight coming up. Bats we of course have. Alright, we're all decked out. I think I already have this, but let's make sure. Alright, here we go. Alright, we're gonna crank the Elgato. I'm not gonna say a word. Good shit. Alright. Put it back down where it was. It's a loud game. I'm keeping my Elgato on minus 12, which I normally don't go down that low, but it's a very loud game by default. Alright. We had to let the song play. The ladder boss fight. Alright, no kills. No alerts. And so far, I'm quite certain we've gotten every animal. Let's eat a rat. Alright, let's get rid of the tarantula. We already ate the bat. Don't need the rat. Don't need the... well, we'll keep the frog. We're pretty low on stuff. Alright, I'm thinking and hoping that... I wish I had more, darts. Hopefully there's some chilling here. No. I'm hoping that the vulture is the last bird. That'd be a good retro achievement one. There might be, for all I know. There's so damn many. Alright, let's see here. I'm gonna put on Infinity Face Paint. Hey, what's up, Koopa? How's it going? Let's see if there's a better... Animals is pretty good. It's interesting how Animals is often better than Chocolate Chip, despite Chocolate Chip being meant for mountain environments. Even better than Desert Tiger. Let's go ahead and for right now use Infinity Face Paint. There's also a reason I'm using bonus items, by the way. If I were to get no kills, no alerts, and get every animal and every plant, but not use a special item, then I would actually get a different rank. I wouldn't get the Markor rank that I'm going for. Alright, let's make sure I've got this snake. Don't know for sure that I have that one. Gonna be sneaky. Snake C, let me take a look at it. Yeah, not yet eaten. I don't think I had that one. Or am I hyped about Delta? I definitely am gonna want to play it. It looks great. I do sort of say sometimes that it's rare for me to really get hyped about games anymore. I still love video games. Like, I'll always love video games. But if I'm being honest when people ask me that question, and I don't know that they mean it, like, super literally, but if I'm being honest, like, I just don't really get hyped for... it's just the truth. Like, you know, you can take a lot of... There's a lot of stuff out there, like Resident Evil 4 Remake. That's this game I wanted to play. But was I hyped for it? Not really. Mario Wonder, good stuff. It's a good game, they did it right. Was I hyped for it? I mean, I don't know. I don't mean to sound like a Debbie Downer, I'm just being honest. Like, I don't know if it's my age or what. I just don't know that I really get hyped for video games anymore. I still like them. I think I'll always like them. But, you know, hopefully what I'm saying makes sense. Yeah. I don't really get hyped for games anymore. Let me save this, by the way, now that we're in a new area and we've done a bunch of stuff. We haven't gotten any alerts. I have a friend who's much more cynical. He said this years ago. Now, I'm not this cynical, but he said, when you become an adult, the only two things that get better in life are sex. There it is. A bird in the hand beats two in the bush. The only two things that get better are drugs and sex. Now, that's maybe being a little cynical. But I will say that, like, I don't get super hyped about video games, even though I do like them. Yeah, you remember the days, like, Ocarina of Time getting close to release, and 13-year-old you couldn't even sleep, you were so hyped. Yeah, exactly. I have just accepted that I will never recapture the feeling of being 10 years old and playing Super Mario 64 for the first time, and recognizing that I can jump into this portrait and be transported into another world. Or when I was 8 years old and I went to movie time and I was like, Donkey Kong Country? What is this? You know, I'm just well past that point. I still love video games. They're kind of my first love, you know? My first memory is of playing Nintendo. But I don't get hyped for video games anymore, just because I just don't. I always watch the directs and stuff. And I look forward to certain games to an extent. I think Delta looks good. Like, the use of Unreal Engine 5 looks really good.
Just my imagination.
The most I can say is that, like, yeah, I think that game looks good. That's the furthest I can go. Hyped? When I think of hyped, and I know some people mean it, like, hyperbolically, but I still think of, like, oh, yeah, dude, like, fuck yeah. I can't wait for that game to come out. Like, I just don't feel that way anymore. You know, like, next month, I'm going to play the Super Mario RPG remake. And I have a feeling it'll be pretty good. Like, I'm not setting my expectations. It's not going to be like the first time I played it on SNES when I was 9. But I think it'll be good. It looks like it's well produced. Hopefully that makes sense. And hopefully there's people that can relate. And I think there are. I think most people can relate. I think most adults can relate. Here we go. There's a dude. Alright, no kills, no alerts. We're doing well. Alright, let's see here. A bird in the hand is better than two in the bush. Did you guys know that? Alright, let's see here. So now, every type of snake, and then Title of Markor. We'll be getting a bunch of these with one playthrough if we play our cards right. But if we miss one or two, you know what they say. A bird in the hand is better than two in the bush. Oh, man. Alright, let's get a save going. I'm doing lots of saves. That's the one thing I'm not worrying about doing a lot. Because we're going for no kills, no alerts. Alright. And we got a helicopter here. Now, I think I want to take Infinity off and replace it with Desert. Get a plus 10 going. I like to be stealthy in this area. Yeah, that's definitely a variable. To me, I wouldn't say that's the only thing, but that's definitely a factor. When you're a kid, you don't care about money, or like in my case, when I was a kid, it's usually that my parents are renting the game. That like we're going to movie time or Blockbuster, and I'm having the game rented that I'm not paying for. That was usually I didn't own or buy or have too many games bought for me when I was a kid. Most of my experiences as a kid playing games were either rentals, playing games at friends' houses, occasionally getting a birthday gift. Yeah, money is a variable too, especially if you pay $60 for a game and you don't have a great time with it. That's obviously not a good thing. But I think it's just that, like, you know, when you're a kid, your perspective is just like, it's just so, like, it just blows you away. Like, you're playing Mario, like I said, Mario 64, Donkey Kong Country 2, it just blows your fucking balls off. And now, if they announced, like, Donkey Kong Country 4 for Switch, I'd be like, oh, neat. But I wouldn't, like, be feeling crazy about it. I have friends that I'll watch the Nintendo Directs with and stuff like that and watch other kind of, like, shows. And some of them definitely still get really hyped. And I'm it's not a knock on them, or it's not me being like, but I'm immature, like that is not what I'm saying at all. I'm just saying, like, if anything, I'm slightly envious, but like certain games will be announced that they like, and like they'll literally like make noise and like get excited. And I almost feel, if anything, I almost feel awkward that I'm like all quiet and don't care. But not literally don't care, but you know what I mean. Like, it's just like, to me, it's like, oh. Like, I saw reaction videos of people responding to Paper Mario, The Thousand Year Door, getting released. I like that game. That's a great game. That's a really good RPG with a great soundtrack and a good story. And I'm glad that it's getting released for another generation. I will likely pick it up. But, like, hyped, like when I watch people have a reaction video where they go, ah! Like I just don't have it anymore. I don't have it anymore. Now, if you still have that magic for games, I don't want to take it away from you. Don't let me, don't let Grandpa Drew here. Yeah, Nintendo is really bad about their... Ha ha ha, wah! That was nuts. Nintendo is really bad about their pricing, their marketing, and not having sales, not having them often. When they do have them, it's the same stock 30% off sale on the same titles. The one thing that I will say that Nintendo has done in recent year, well, has done recently that is a reasonably good deal is they have this new voucher system where if there are two $60 games that you're going to want to get. So in my case, it was like Super Mario Brothers Wonder. I wanted to get that game. Super Mario RPG Remake. I wanted to get that game. So together, it's $120 if I were to just buy them both. But with the voucher system, it's $100 and you can buy two games. But you get all of the My Nintendo gold coins that you would otherwise get. And I already had some saved up, along with some eShop credit left over from an old gift card someone gave me. So like... when I added it all up, gold coins, gift card, voucher system, I basically got to buy one, get one free, essentially. So, as we get closer to Paper Mario, if there's another good-looking Nintendo game that interests me, you know, and I've got some, like right now, I think I have like $5 worth of those coins saved up. If there's like another game and I can, you know, make something work, then that would be cool. All right. I do like this crazy, like there are moments in this game where using the old camera is useful. Look at this. If I were you, Rip, I would just wait for the successor to the Switch. My advice to anyone who is thinking about, I'm thinking about getting a new dock, or I'm thinking about getting an OLED, or I'm thinking about, sometimes I want to get a Switch Lite, or anything like that. My advice would be, just wait for the successor to the Switch. I think it'll come out in about a year. I think they'd be fools not to make it fully backwards compatible. I don't think it's gonna be like a PS5, but I think in comparison, I think that it will be kind of a, based on all the rumors and leaks that we know about it so far, not that they're all like slam dunk evidence, but I get the impression that since Nintendo is sticking with the same format of making a hybrid console, that there's no other place to really put the focus but to really to up the horsepower this time, which they haven't really done. That really hasn't been their focus since the GameCube, arguably. Wasn't their focus with the Wii. Maybe with the Wii U, but I think their focus was more on making that sort of like, having that second screen and, you know, it was kind of PS3 360 level in 2012. Switch was obviously all about the hybrid functionality. A Switch 2, there's nowhere to go but just to beef it up. Unless they have some other trick up their sleeve. But yeah, I don't know how cheap docks are, so maybe I shouldn't. It could be that they're just really cheap. Alright, here we go. Let's see here. This stupid-ass helicopter is pissing me off. I will say that at the time, I enjoyed the Wii. I think the Wii, if you had component cables and were playing it on a CRT and were kind of viewing it as a beefed up GameCube, and I remember enjoying Twilight Princess shit on my Wii. I knew what the specs were going in, so it's not like I was like, "Hey, this is an HD." Hold on, god damn it! Ugh. These bastards. These guys are bastards. Yeah, I just remember having a good time with that system. Between like Twilight Princess, WarioWare, and even some of the gimmicky stuff, Excite Truck. You mean you have to use your hands? It's like a baby's toy. I need more darts. No, don't send reinforcements. That's like a baby's toy. You know that that's, fucking what's-his-face. His name's slipping my mind. Dude from one of the Lord of the Rings. Guy from Sin City. Oh, thank you. Elijah Wood. Thank you. That was his first role in a movie. Back to the Future 2. Kid saying that. I have to be really careful. Go away, helicopter. How far can I get this guy with the cigarette spray? Ah! We're fucked. I have to reload my save.
Snake, come on, say something.
I didn't bring my parachute. I didn't bring my parachute. They definitely went overboard. Like, here are Wii wrist straps. Wear them. Every game had the intro. Put them on. Secure it. Put on the Wii condom, the Wiimote condom, the wrist strap. Keep them on at all times, no matter what you're playing. You know, they were definitely, How far back is this save? Okay, I'm glad it's here. I was wondering if I hadn't saved into the last area. Yeah, I'm sure. They learned. Nintendo is as, like... frugal, it sounds too nice. Frugal is the word that keeps coming to mind. Cautious, frugal, cheap, careful. There's a bunch of words you could use to describe Nintendo. Greedy. They do not want lawsuits. They want money. They want maximum money. Maximum profits. I mean, obviously they're a business. But they do not care. They know what their reputation is. And they don't give a shit. They don't. Their attitude is like 100%. You want this new first-party Zelda or Mario or Wario or Smash Brothers or Animal Crossing game, you're paying full $60, and we're not putting it on sale, not for 2 years. And when we do, it's just going to be by 30%. And you're going to buy it. Because you can't get this on PlayStation. If you don't like it, complain about it on Reddit. We don't care. Make a tweet. I don't give a shit. Yeah, we all do. I bought Wonder. I bought RPG. They don't give you a choice. You know you want to play Mario Wonder. Alright, I hope this guy can't see me at 85%. That helicopter makes me nervous. It is crazy seeing this old PS2 style camera, but there are occasions where it's useful. If you click in R3, you can revert to the old camera, and there are those moments where it comes in handy. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Nintendo fanboys are very, very real. That's a very real thing. I will say that, like, I hate fanboyism, period. And the reason why should be obvious. Fanboyism should have been left behind on the middle school, or I would say elementary school, school bus. By the time you reach the age of middle school, no one should be arguing about Nintendo or PlayStation versus Xbox. Now, if you wanted to have a pragmatic conversation, obviously that's different. Like, it's normal to want to know, so which one of these is more powerful? And it's like, oh, well, you know, the Xbox has a slightly better GPU, the PS5's GPU is faster, you have a faster solid-state drive on PS5, the Series X has slightly faster clock speed on the CPU. That's like normal adult conversation and purchasing decision. Okay. But fanboyism is very much real and alive, and it's unreal to me how much people still are fanboys for companies or franchises.
I could go for seconds.
And yeah, that's a really also a, that's a that's another. When I'm at the gym, a lot of times what they're playing on TV is ESPN, and watching like Stephen A and some other random like dude argue about two athletes is also really cringe. It's in the same category. It's really, really, really cringy. Especially when they look at each other all heated. Like, I'll just do an impression. Like, one of them will be like, oh, you think Anderson's gonna carry the team? You think Anderson by himself is going to carry the team? No, you're telling me that right now. And they get all serious. It's like, who's Anderson? Who gives a shit? What team? Why do you care? Like, what the fuck? It's weird with sports. It's weird with video games. It's weird. It's just weird. I hate it. I understand it for elementary school kids who they have a Sega Genesis and they want a Super Nintendo and their friends argue about it on the school bus because they're in second grade. I understand that. That's what children do. What's amazing is how many adults do it to this day on Reddit, on Twitter, on Discord, and are fucking serious. I've had to ban people before because all they would do is get into these really heated, childish arguments about fucking video games. Just because it's all that they would want to do. And I'm totally fine with, like, discussion and even debate. Like, we can debate shit, but, like, as adults, please? You know? Like, pragmatically looking at the facts. Not getting, like, super invested in emotional feelings over Mario or Metal Gear. Or... Like, if someone were to hate Snake Eater, I don't give a shit. Now, it would be annoying if they want to come in here and, like, spend 3 hours going on and on and on about it, and at a certain point, it's kind of like, alright, dude, I get it. Like, I understand where you're coming from. I don't agree, but can you let it go? But it's just amazing, dude. It's amazing how much of it is online. Like, I've seen, like, people when a PlayStation version or an Xbox version of a game isn't great. I've seen people who own an Xbox be like, yeah, we gotta win on this one. It's like, what? You got a win on this one because the Series X version of the game renders at 1900p and the PS5 version of the game renders at 1824p. And you want to, like, parade around about it as if it has anything to do with you or anything. It's just so... Ugh, I hate it. It's so... It's insanity. It's literally crazy. Alright, we did good here. Me too. Yeah, me too. More, yeah, that's always been my view on it. Now, you know, when that happens, I'm going to look at the different versions. I'm going to see, I'm probably going to buy it for the most powerful machine I own, which right now is my PS5. You know, my CPU is failing, my motherboard, my CPU or my motherboard, one of the two is failing right now, and my GPU is roughly on par with what's in the PS5. It's an RTX 2070 Super. I have more memory in my computer, but it's not as fast. So, I'm just going to get the PS5 version. Hold on, let me get a save going. Yeah, it's wild. It's something that I understood, like, as a kid. It just amazes me that it's still... you still see it with adults. And not just, like, teens or even early 20s, but, like, men in their 30s or 40s who will still get invested in arguments over consoles or companies or franchises. It's one of, like, the biggest things that I just get sick of. It's been a while since I've talked about it at length like this. But there are times where it can be a factor. It can be one of the factors in burning me out from streaming. Not lately, but I've definitely gone through periods on my past channel where it's just like, whew. Not much. Just wanted to shoot you in the face. Okay. Sensor. Hop up. Hop up. Oh, something there? No.
I must be seeing
things. Yeah, you're seeing things. See a doctor. There we go. Wait for it to go by. Go away. I want to just break out my rocket launcher and just fucking destroy that thing. But I can't. Someone there? Must be my imagination. All right.
Do you know where
exactly one of these cutscenes, I have to let these play. One of these has a hidden R1 perspective for the Snake Eyes trophy. And I believe it's towards the end of this cutscene, but I'm going to let it play. I'm going to let this one rip. Because R1 will show... I'll get to see the boss ride off in her horse, and I think that you'll also see Ocelot do his little, like, thing. Then, go through the passageway on the second floor of the main wing. I'm just holding R1,
though. The west wing of the weapons lab. Got it.
There's just one problem.
Not again.
The west wing is protected by the highest level of security. You need to be Colonel class to get in.
Colonel class?
Here. Look at this picture. Major Ivan Rydenovich Rykov. Pretend you're him.
How do I do that?
I don't know if it's a codec call or if they bring it up now. But I think it's a codec call where Snake raises a question.
Your face might be a problem. So you just have to figure something out.
Which is he should be somewhere in the which is a good question. Which is how is this going to work if Rydenovich is a major? How can he be Colonel class? He's a major.
But how am I supposed to escape once I get Sokolov out of there? Command said you're supposed to have something ready for me.
And I do. There's a lake 30 miles north of here. I hid a wig there.
A wig?
What kind of wig? What color?
Ground effect vehicle.
A ground effect vehicle? I can't fly one of those.
That's okay. I happen to be an excellent pilot.
Taking off from a lake is trickier than it looks. It's not like riding a motorcycle. You've got to be more delicate.
Of course I will. You've seen how good I am with the bike, right?
Uh-oh. Scuffed boots!
Right. You handle the escape, then. I'll head for Groznygrad.
Wait a minute. There's something I wanted to ask you.
What?
What's the story between you and the boss?
She was like a mother, and my master.
And your lover?
It went deeper than that.
Deeper?
Half of me belongs to the boss.
Do you love her?
No, nothing like that.
For up-res PlayStation 2 models, they do look pretty good. They have awkward facial animation, but...
Between a man and a woman?
They're the same polygon count as the original PS2 models.
For 10 years, we lived and died.
Compare that to like a PS1 model. Understand. Up-res'd or not.
And you think you can...
It's a pretty big generational leap that we had. Going from 5th gen to 6th gen.
That's your mission, isn't it? Assassinating the boss?
Like, there's obvious simplicity with the hair and stuff, but... All things considered, I still think it looks pretty good.
Is there anyone you like? Someone special?
I do hope they patch these. I hope they listen to the criticism, though, and patch these to render higher than 720p. This is still a 720p render running on a native PlayStation 5 app.
It was in your best interest to assist me.
Casual with 100 bits. You're going to shoot to sleep. Got an early gym session, then lunch with your brother. Nice. Have fun with the rest. I will. Thank you for the 100 bits, man. I appreciate it.
I can fall in love if it's part of the mission.
Appreciate it very much. Whoa. Eva. Didn't ask you to do that.
Snake?
Uh-oh. This is the next cutscene. This is the one. Does she zip herself back up? I don't remember. Nope. Alright, this is the one where if I hold R1 at a certain point, I'm gonna get a kind of special glimpse.
See you around, Snake. Take care of yourself.
What about you?
Not just an Eva.
I've got to hurry back and play my other part.
Are you going to be okay?
Not sure. They're not stupid, and they know there's a spy. There's no way you could have gotten this far all by yourself.
Hey. You'd think someone at the fortress would be like, hey! There's a motorcycle flying in the air. Alright, it's coming up. There's gotta be some guard in a tower that's like, yo! There she goes. Yeah, exactly. Uh-oh. Vulcan's such an asshole, he's always like... There it is. Whoa, he's going Mike Tyson's punch out. There goes Granin, the creator of Metal Gear, the original creator of Metal Gear, dead. 1964. Rest in peace.
Did he talk?
No. He died before I could get it out of him.
Well, maybe you couldn't hear him through the barrel. If in reality it's like, I'll tell you.
Spy, then.
Look at this.
A transmitter?
Exactly. Planted to keep someone informed of his location.
But does this mean Granin was the spy?
Perhaps he was being used by someone else.
Perhaps. This man was our comrade.
Comrade or not, he's of no use to us now.
I don't approve of your methods.
I don't need your approval. I'm in command here.
And that nuclear shell?
Still feeling sore about that, are you? What are you gonna do? Report it to the authorities? This is war, Major. A cold war, fought with information and espionage. We must root out spies wherever they hide. It is kill or be killed. Potential threats must be weeded out. Your feelings are a menace to the unity of our organization. Someone is guiding the enemy's hand. A single man can only accomplish so much. Make no mistake, there is a spy among us.
But casting suspicion on our own comrades.
The C-3 explosives have been stolen.
You think it was the American?
No. He could not have reached this fortress yet.
There he is, you can see him in the background. You can see Snake kind of watching over.
Who?
I'd be careful about suspecting your own men.
Boss.
There's Tatiana.
Where have you been?
The fear and the end have fallen.
Damn it. CIA dog?
I don't know anything about 1960s Russian military ranks.
How can the legendary Cobras be
but why?
So
I'm wondering why
he's good.
Volgan has 3 stars. On his shoulder, and Ocelot has 4.
Don't worry.
When Ocelot's a major,
I'll take care of him.
And Volgan's a colonel.
What is he after? Must be more than just Sokolov.
America is out to destroy the Shagohod and get its hands on your inheritance. The philosopher's legacy.
Huh? Impossible. The legacy, it.
All right, pretty soon I think
You're
I've got my
me as well.
I've got my sneaky
Colonel, tighten the security on this.
All right,
place.
Gotta hold R1.
He's coming here, I'm sure of it. I'm gonna get the Davy Crockett.
There it is. That's it. Hopefully, I don't have to, like, get the whole thing. I can just get a part of it. I don't know exactly how it works. But that seemed to be it.
Boots. Make sure you polish them up properly.
There's another one. I want to make sure I got that one. I have a notepad thing here. Snake will continue to watch, see the boss, watch the boss starts leaving around the hold R button to watch her right away from Snake's perspective. Okay, next one will be during the torture. Near the end of the torture scene and after Ocelot shoots Snake's eyes, Ocelot will start to leave the room. Hold R1 to look at the boss's face as he leaves. Okay. So that'll be after I get caught. I think I'm good to go in terms of animals. We haven't gotten any alerts or anything yet. Let's see if we can grab a bite. Can't complain. Krasnogorhei Mountaintop Ruins. Hold on. I think I'm quite sure I've already gotten the Emperor Scorpion, but I like to make sure. Ain't nothing wrong. Getting more than one. Alright. Instant noodles. Let's get rid of the vulture. Let's get rid of the frog. Alright. Mountaintop City. This is going to be a good spot to save for sure. We accomplished quite a bit.
Snake.
The blob. I've heard the blob from Clay Fighter. Does that count? Look at this guy. Look at this guy. He thinks he's all that in a bag of chips. Me and Oni Link, we know better. We know never to trust a man carrying flame stuff on his back. That's what Oni Link used to always say to me. Oh shit. Got him. Got him. That guy's heading down. I'm gonna deliberately hurt my shin. Now you might ask, why would you do that? Every time you cure in this game, it extends your health bar. And I've got plenty of bandages and splints. If I'm feeling crazy, I might even do it again. Ooh, I'm out of... Let's put on my AP sensor. Ooh, I hear what's wrong. I don't like hearing that. Something there. Nope. Nope. But, Houston, we do have a problem. Now that we're near the Fury. I'm gonna need, MK rounds against this guy. And there might be some down here. I think there's some over here, maybe. Nope. We're gonna look around. Hopefully some here. Bandages and ointment. There, we got them. Alright, with the Infinity face paint, we'll be good now. It's here again. Battery. Those are good. Alright, I'm wondering something. These are combustible, and if so, if I want to get burned by them. Yeah. Because I got ointment. You might be thinking I'm crazy. Look at that health bar go up. Whoop! Eat this bad scorpion. Alright. Can I get burned again? Whoa. Stop, drop, and roll, Snake. My god. I got burned again during that, but that's okay. Alright, we got even more health. Alright, there we go. Now we got more ointment! You guys didn't think I knew what I was doing, but I knew. I knew. Alrighty. I will save.
Snake, you know the bridge on the River Kwai?
Nope.
Haven't seen it.
It's about a group of Allied prisoners in Japanese-occupied Burma in World War II who worked together to build a bridge. Under the leadership of an English officer, the prisoners and the Japanese gradually bring the project toward completion. But at the same time, the Allied forces are hatching a plan to blow up the bridge.
War and futility go hand in hand.
I suppose so.
I didn't think you were the type to go for war movies, though.
She's already named a bunch.
Actually, this guy invited me to go see it with him.
A date?
I guess you could call it that.
Still, you just don't seem like the type.
Well, he seemed to like war movies. He was a Navy boy. I was still an intern back then. They brought him in with
also, she's in the military.
He said, when I'm all
she's paramedic.
Up, will you go see a movie with me to celebrate? If it's okay. He was so shy.
Where is he now?
With the 7th Fleet.
I see.
I want to hear the rest of the romance. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and save here for today. I see. Yeah, Snake wanted to know more too. Alright, we're gonna save it here for today. I hope you guys enjoyed hanging out. I appreciate all of you hanging out for the stream. We're making good progress for our trophies and our with our run here. Let's take a look here. Let's see who's live. I'm gonna raid Cousin Catnip. He's playing Super Mario Brothers Wonder. Let's give him a raid if y'all don't mind joining me. Raid Cousin Catnip. Anyway, like I said, appreciate y'all hanging out. We'll probably finish this next time. The next stream of this will be part 3, and we should be able to go ahead and get her done. We got most of the major stuff knocked out. But anyway, I'm going to wrap up here, and I'll see y'all real soon.